In this video, you learn how to insert a circuit breaker into a breaker panel and how to connect an appliance to the breaker. Watch the other videos in this series to see the unboxing and then the mounting and installation of a GE electric vehicle charging station. Please subscribe to CB99 Videos.
So in addition to the charging station itself, we need to have a way to connect it to the electrical service. In this case, what we're going to show you is a situation where we have a sub-panel in the garage, so we don't need much conduit to go from the circuit panel to the charging station. So we've bought a 6-foot piece of conduit. It's come pre-wired with 8-gauge wire, and this is a $16 item at Lowe's. And the 8-gauge wire is so that we can draw up to 40 amps out of the circuit panel to the charging station. So the 40 amp breaker I have right here is a double pole breaker that delivers 240 volts. Your actual circuit breaker may look different. You may have square D. This is an Eaton. So you're going to have to check the make of your circuit panel and get this the appropriate breaker. The other interesting thing to note is that the sub panel that we have in the garage is a 100 amp panel. So we can put a 40-amp breaker in that sub-panel without a problem.
A few extra tools that you'll need for this job are a hammer, flathead screwdrivers, a Phillips head screwdriver, electrician's pliers, wire strippers, vice grips, a round file, maybe a flat file, and wire cutters.
Here we are at the main circuit breaker panel for the house. And we're going to install the charging station in the garage, and there's a sub-panel in the garage. So to be safe, we're going to turn off the electricity of the sub-panel. And we're going to do that by just flipping this 100-amp breaker over like that. So now we don't have any electricity in the garage circuit breaker panel, and it'll be safe to work on that panel. So now we're going to take the face of the panel off so that we can install the circuit breaker that we buy in the store. You always want to do one of the top ones last. Okay, this is the inside of the 100 amp sub panel in the garage. This is where you put your breakers. This is the common or neutral bus bars. And then we have the ground bus bar here. Now the ground bus bar is where we're gonna tie in the green wire here. So this is where we hook up the red and the black wire. The red and the black wire are gonna go in here like this.
Perfect.
We're gonna strip it. Obviously, but so the point is that we don't have a lot of wire here, so I want this conduit to come into the box very close to the ground where the green wire has to connect to. So that means I'm going to put my breaker right here, and I'm going to put it in this position, just like that.
Cool.
Okay, now the next step is I'm going to take this knockout out here so that I can bring the wire in right in here. And the way you do that is you punch it out with the screwdriver. And you can use a hammer to facilitate that. Okay, a pair of electrical pliers is perfect for this situation. And we're going to use the pliers to break off this piece of the knockout here. Okay, so we're gonna need a file to file those tabs off. So we used a round file to trim off the little burrs here, or the knockout out, and now we have to remove this nut here. And then we put this in here like this. I'm going to use this on the inside here because that'll make it stronger. You know, it's hard to knock a knockout out without affecting the concentric parts. So I'm going to do this. That'll make it more secure.
So that washer came with the whip?
With the whip, yeah. That was part of the whip. And then you use your trusty hammer here. I'm going to strip the leads here so that we can connect it up to the circuit breaker. And I'm going to go gently around here with these cutters. And the idea is to break through the insulation, but not to nick the copper. Yeah, there we go. And then we do the same thing for the red. And again, the red and the black here are, for this situation here, there's no difference between them. You don't have to worry about which side the red goes on and which side the black goes on. So you strip about that much insulation off, and then you back the nut out, or the screw out. And as you can see, that opens up the hole. As you can see, as I screw it down, we're clamping, right? But you want to open it up so there's a nice big gap there where you can push the wire in. You want to push the wire in until it bottoms out, and making sure that the insulation isn't going to be clamped. And then you clamp it by tightening the screw. And you do the same thing with this side. And you don't want to strip out so much insulation that you have bare
wire showing up.
So now we have the circuit breaker hooked up. And then we'll pick one of these ground terminals. We'll pick the bottom one here, and we'll back that out. And I want to call attention here. This is the ground bus bar, not to be confused with the neutral bus bars, which are here on either side. And here, this electric car charging station does not need a neutral. Okay, so we tighten that up, make sure that's good and tight. And then we can just take our circuit breaker, so we hook it there, then we push, and then we're done. You now have a fully connected electric charging station. We're going to put the panel door back on, but before we do that, we have to punch out the hole for this new breaker. So we're going to punch out these two blanks right here, which are 21 and 23. So I'm going to take these things out.
By just pushing down.
By just levering these out. Once I got them pried out a little bit, then I'm going to switch over to my handy electrician's pliers. And I do this, and it just fatigues the metal until it pops out. Okay. Okay, let's get the ones in that threaded nicely. So now you have your electric car charging station circuit breaker ready to go.
And it is on the off position right now.
Hey, thanks for watching. And please subscribe to CB99 videos. And you might like the other two videos in this series.